G'day guys, it's John from Honeybee Acres with another Animals of Honeybee Acres for you. In this one, we've got some really good stuff. I've really enjoyed putting this one together. So we've got some deer again that we've been seeing them the last few weeks. They are starting to come up to the rut, so that's not unusual. We've got some wallabies again. We've got a wombat. We've got quite a bit of wombat footage of one particular wombat. And we've got a couple of new ones as well. So we've got some stuff we haven't seen before, which I won't spoil it for you now. I'll let you wait for that. And we've got some other ferals that we haven't seen before as well. So let's get into it. All right, so first up, we've got this buck. Nice antlers on there. Just having a little look around. And looks like a buck with just little buds has come to have a look. And he's very curious about the camera. And yeah, it gives it a bit of a nudge. Luckily he didn't do any damage, but they're pretty tough cameras, the trail cams we've got. I wouldn't expect it to be able to do too much damage. Here we've got a little rat. Now I very much suspect this is an introduced feral rat, not anything native. At least I hope it, not to give away too much, but I hope it is a feral rat, because here comes along kitty cat. And here's the cat back again, and it looks like it's got that rat in its mouth. So I hope it was a feral. I'm not a big fan of cats. Cats are all right for those people who like them, but they do obviously kill a lot of native animals in Australia, which isn't a great thing. And here we've got a white-winged chough. So these birds live in a family lot. It's a bit unusual to see them by themselves, but I suspect that their family is probably outside of the shot of the camera. And it's just having a look around to see what it can find. They feed a lot on vegetation, seeds and stuff like that, and probably insects as well. But we have a fair few of them around the place here. Big family that hangs around. And that was a bit of a foxtail there. Barely got it in there. And here we've got a wallaby just wandering around at night, just having a look around, looking for something to graze. And here's one in the daytime. So they often do this one. Looks like it's probably got like some short, or that does have short grass there, but it looks like it's getting a bit of dirt as well. So it's not unusual for animals to get a bit of dirt from time to time, especially herbivorous animals. That just gives them minerals and stuff that they don't usually get in their diet. From the vegetation that they eat. And this one's a boy. If you know, you know. And there he is again, just having a look around. And they're lovely things, the wallabies. And the forest is where you see them. That's their normal place. You do see kangaroos in the forest. Obviously, we've had plenty of videos with kangaroos in them. But wallabies, they're forest-dwelling macropods, and the kangaroos tend to spend a lot more time out in the open grass fields, the plains, and that sort of thing. Here he's again, still hanging around. He's and that's just a wombat burrow that he's at there, so obviously there's food for wallabies there as well as wombats. All right, so here's a wallaby in a different location now. This is some more of open forest rather than near a wombat hole. And it's a different spot on our block as well. The previous footage was from a fairly damp area of our block, sort of near the road. This is higher up the hill where it's a lot drier and a bit more open, so you don't get as many shadows. And yeah, it's a nice looking wallaby, nice and healthy. How long that tail is. Just having a little bit of a look around and a forage. And this shot here, just coming into the shot of the camera now, is one of our local wombats. Bit hard to tell if this one's a male or female. Their reproductive organs aren't as obvious as what they are on male wallabies. And he's just having a bit of a sniff around the place. And nocturnal animals, wombats are. Wallabies tend to be as well, but you do see them around a fair bit during the daytime. But wombats, pretty much mostly nocturnal. If you see them out during the day, they're generally not well. And usually they've got a condition called mange, which is caused by mites. But looking at this wombat here, nice coat, no sign of mange on this wombat, which is really, really good. We've never really seen any wombats around our area with mange, which is really good, but it definitely is in places not too far away from here. So hopefully our wombats can stay healthy. I'm just heading down into the burrow there. This is actually a burrow that's nice and dry. So we do have one that wombats have been in that's pretty much been submerged in water for most of the end of 2023 and certainly for a while in the beginning of 2024. It's fairly well submerged. We actually get a fair bit of this wombat wandering around. Some people might get a little bit bored, but that's a shame because, yeah, I love the wombats. They're great little creatures. They actually can do a bit of damage to people's property because they dig up, but the soil conditioners of Australia, they dig burrows, which turns the soil over. Burrows get used over time and aren't that great anymore, so they move on to different ones. And like a burrow will slowly subside and different places will get dug up. So they do play a role in the environment in terms of turning soil over. And just having a look down in this burrow here. He seems to be having a good look, not really going in there. You can see a mark on the side there, so you'll see that in some daytime footage coming up, but it looks like maybe a bit of a wound there, so it doesn't look like mange to me, but maybe a bit of a wound, or it could just be where the fur's damp, where it's been in a wet area, rubbed up against something that was wet, and we'll be able to have a different look in a second. So this is the same wombat in the daytime. And this is the same burrow, just having another look. And it heads on down. And it's popped out again, walks away. And it's back down again. So for where this burrow is, looking at the long shadows there, I'd say this has all happened in sort of early morning. And this wombat's probably been out foraging around the place all night and probably just about heading down to go to sleep in this burrow. So that'll be this wombat for the day. It'll sleep in there during the daytime. It'll come back out at night. And here's something new. So this is a lyrebird. So these are an Australian native bird. And this one's probably just scratching around, but I'd love to get a trail cam with a mic on it because these birds are mimics and they mimic all sorts of things, all sorts of different birds, any other noises that they hear around the place. They're amazing. Here we've got a possum, big brush-tailed possum. So brush-tailed possums are one of the larger possums that we have in Australia. And it just sort of walks into shot and walks out. And here we have an echidna, just a little shot of its back. And echidnas are fascinating. They're one of two monotremes in the world, which are mammals that lay eggs. And the other one is the platypus. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. It was good to see the echidna and the possum and the lyrebird, things we haven't seen before. Not so good to see the cat, even though it did catch the rat, which was a feral rat. and the fox tail, as well, the tail of the fox that we saw as well. Not good to see the ferals about, but luckily for us, we have chickens and we have never had a fox take a chicken. So touch wood, there's some right there. Hopefully we don't have any trouble with foxes, but yes, they're definitely around. So I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, just leave a comment below. Let me know what was your favorite animal in this video. And if you want to, what was your least favorite as well? And give it a like and subscribe to my channel to keep up with what we're doing here on Honeybee Acres. And I hope to see you again. Bye.